Are you tired at staring at a white Xcode project all day long? Well, fear no more, because today I will teach you how you can add a custom Xcode theme. And while we are at it, we are going to add a really, really cool font called Fira Code. So, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. Let's open up Xcode, hit that subscribe button, and let's dive in. Being a developer is really, really hard. You have to look at a screen, well, at least 8 hours a day, am I right? So, if you are looking at Xcode and you are not using a custom theme, you are missing out and you are hurting your eyes. So today, I will just show you how you can add Fira Code, a font, a really, really cool font, and also XCODE-ONE, a really, really nice Xcode template. Before we jump into it, let me just remind you about the Dev Factory. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. I am going to help you in 1 hour on a one-on-one Zoom call with your bugs, with your any questions that you have regarding Xcode or Swift or Swift UI. So go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. So let's install Fira Code. So Fira Code, it's at github.com/tomsky/firacode, you will have the links down in the description, so in the resources of the description. So go ahead and check it out, and what you have to do is just basically click on this big download button. It will download Fira Code, and let me just open this in Finder. Okay, so what you have to do is just go ahead and open up all of these font files. So you just go ahead and double click on them. It's already installed on my computer, so I won't do that, but make sure that you install all of the fonts that you want to use. Okay, so TTF is okay. So that's one thing. So you will have Fira Code available. Now, why Fira Code? Let me just open up Xcode here. And there we go. So this is the basic one. You know, it's white and it has this default font, but yeah, it's kind of ugly to look at and to read. So if you just go to Xcode and preferences, you can set your theme under themes. And what we are going to add is OneDark. And if you just take a look at OneDark, has Fira Code Retina. Now you could just go to the classic or the basic and change the font right over here if you wanted to, if that's what you want to. But let me just change this back to OneDark Rebeloper, which is basically the same as OneDark that we are going to install in just a second, but with larger fonts. So you can see it on these videos. So what this does is, let me just show you some cool little tricks here. So if you just, first of all, this is much, much better for the eye, as you can see. Now, second, let's just create a func here. A function, let's say, do something. And if you just add a return, you will see that now it will just change to this arrow. Now, that's a lot more readable. Let it be a bool, why not? And here, let's just add a ternary operator. Now, ternary operators, if you don't know, we have a statement or that has a true or false value, and we assign some values according to that. So let's just go 0 equals, and now you see that this double equals is transformed into this really long equal, which is really, really nice to read. Equals 0, then let's just go and let's just go true and false. Okay, now this is really a simple one, but false will never be executed. Okay, it's not about the function. But what if I wanted to make this like is not equals? I just go on, not equals is actually exclamation mark and equals. And this is much more readable. Or what about smaller than equals? So this is really nice, and this comes with Fira Code. Now, with Fira Code, I like to use this XCODE-ONE theme that can be found. Let me just go to Safari. So at Again, it's a GitHub repository at Bojan, XCODE-ONE-DARK. So what you have to do here, you can see it's actually an Xcode color theme. So what you want to do is download the zip file. Let's just wait for that. Okay. And now let me just open this up. There we go. Now you can see that we have our color theme. So you have to add this into your user data under Xcode, and it's right over here. So what you want to do is just copy all of this out. So select all of that, hit Command C, and open up a Finder. And well, you can't see it here, but if you just go on the menu, go to folder, this will pop up and you can just paste it in there, as you can see, and then just go ahead and click on go and you will be taken there. Now what you want to do is just paste that in there, font and color themes. Now if this folder doesn't exist, make sure that you create it. Now here we have it, one dark, it's already there, one dark the Rebeloper. Now how do you actually add this to your Xcode project? Now let's just go back to Xcode, and on the menu just go Xcode and preferences, and this will pop up. Okay, now under themes you will have your custom themes already, but you won't have this Rebeloper, of course. So here we go, one dark, it has Fira Code, all of that. So if you want to make it a little bit larger, so let's say I want to make one dark Rebeloper, let's just select this one and right click on, or maybe I just want to, yes, duplicate it on the plus button. Let's just duplicate one dark two, that's okay. And let's say I want to increase the font size. So now you can select all the colors, but I really do like the colors. So I'm just selecting all of that and just making it, I don't know, maybe 36. And you can see that it's actually how that will be, okay? If you just go to console, I left the console as is. I really like it that it's a little bit smaller, okay? And now, yeah, if I just close this, you see, we have that new one. Of course, I don't want to have this one. So let's just go to preferences and one dark Rebeloper, because that's a little bit larger, of 17 points, and I will just remove this. Okay, so that's great, but how do you actually add this to also Terminal? Well, that's really easy. So just open up Terminal, because yeah, we kind of tend to use Terminal. So yeah, the default one, and I would just go to Terminal Preferences. The default one is this basic. So it's actually black and with white font. Yeah, it's kind of good, but with these white fonts I don't really like that. So let's create a new one, and what I usually do is just start off with one. So let's just create the plus button, and I will just name this Atom 1. Okay, that's great. So now we should choose Atom 1. And by the way, you should just set it to default. So now Atom 1 is the default. And what I want to do is, here we have the font, I want to change it. So let's change the font. And let me just move this right over here. Family, and that will be Fira Code. And you can also already see the changes, okay? That's Fira Code, that's great, that's for the font. But I also want to change the font colors, so colors and effects. Here we have text, and here we have the background. So how do we actually get the text and background? Well, we come back here under Xcode Preferences, okay? And here you can see that this is actually, when I select any of these, you see the actual color of the font. So I like this one. So let me just open that up and make sure that you select RGB sliders and select the hex code. Okay, there we go. We can just simply close all of that. Let's move back to Terminal. And now for the font color, let's just choose right over here, just paste it in there. And yeah, basically that's it. Hit return, and the font will be applied. Okay, that's one thing. Now for the background. So again, we just go to Xcode preferences, open that up. Now here is the background. So I will just choose that one again, copy out the hex color, go back to terminal, and here is our background. So let's just paste it in there, hit return, and now we have what we actually want. Of course, you can customize it further if you wanted to, but I really, really like this style. This is what I usually, well, this is what I've been working in front of for the last year or two. It's really, really well made for the eye, the font, and also the custom theme in Xcode. Okay, so go ahead and check out the link in the description for the resources link, and inside there you will find all of the links that you need for this. And don't forget, if you do want to meet with me on 1 hour Zoom call, maybe you have some bugs, maybe you want to create a new app, or you just want to learn some new cool Swift UI stuff, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. Finally, you don't have to stare at the white Xcode project anymore. Your eyes will thank you for this. So, if you did like this video, or if you do want to see more videos like this one, go ahead and hit that like button. And while you are at it, make sure to hit that notification bell also. Because in the next video, I will be talking about Swift UI, Swift stuff, as usual. And I will see you in the next one.